हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम रोहन सर फ्रॉम मेहदी इंग्लिश स्कूल एंड आई वेलकम माय डियर सेकंड स्टैंडर्ड स्टूडेंट्स वंस अगेन इन इंग्लिश लेक्चर. माय डियर लिटिल चैम्प्स, आई होप दैट यू हैव वॉच्ड माय प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर इन विच आई हैव गिवन यू द वर्कशीट ऑफ पोएम नंबर 2. And I hope that you were also speaking the answers along with me and you were repeating whenever you were asked to do so. My dear little champs, see, unless you want practice, you won't get perfection. Isn't it so? So that's why I have given you the worksheet so that you can practice it again and again. And if you remember the story, you will not have to mug up the answers, you will not have to learn the answers thoroughly. You will be able to write the answers on your own also. So let's see, what are we going to do today? So in today's lecture, first of all, we are going to complete poem number 2, True or False, which in the previous lecture we have left out. And after completing that, we are going to move on with lesson number 3 and 4 worksheet. Make sure, students, that lesson number 3 and 4 worksheet is combined. It is club. Means 3 and 4 worksheet is joined together. It is shuffled. So, first of all, whenever I bring the question on the screen, you have to first understand that this question, particular question, is of which lesson. Correct? Lesson number 4, which recently we have completed, and lesson number 3, which we have completed far back in the previous lectures. Okay? So I hope that now you will pay attention here in this lecture and you will take the keen interest in this lecture. So let us move on to poem number 2. State whether the following statements are true or false, which we have just left out in the previous lecture. So question 1 is, the stew in the land of the Bumblebee is made of pumpkin skin. So the stew is made up of pumpkin skin. So again, if you are holding the book, I hope that you are holding the textbook, because in the previous lecture itself I gave you this message that you always have to keep the textbook when you are solving the worksheet. So do you think the stew was made up of the pumpkin skin? So this statement is false statement. It was clearly written that dandelion stew. So nowhere pumpkin is used for the stew. Okay? So this statement is false statement. Moving on to the second statement. Poet calls Bumblebee the wonderful Bumblebee. Yes, if you see in the last paragraphs, he says that wonderful Bumblebee. So this statement is there. Okay, so is this right? Yes, this statement is right. It is true statement. Moving on to the third one. The people of Bumblebee never blow bubbles. We can say that this statement is not true. Why? Because people of Bumblebee never blow their noses. This is heard, but never blow bubbles. No, this statement is false, because this is what we have not heard in the poem. The fourth statement is, the people of Bumblebee wore clothes of pelican feathers. Have you seen anywhere this word use feathers in the poem? No. We discussed a lot of times in the previous lecture, we discussed each and every stanza, but we have never gone through this word feathers. So this statement is also false statement. Now students, moving on to lesson number 3 and 4 worksheet. So here I hope the textbooks are with you, because the questions are shuffled. Sometimes you will get lesson number 3 question, or sometimes you will get lesson number 4 question. For that you need to pay carefully the attention here, and also you should be remembering the story in your mind. Okay, only then you will be able to answer. So let's see, choose the correct answer. So first of all, you will get the questions again, for which you will get the options, and you need to choose the correct answer for it. Okay? So moving on to the first question. Who gives Inspector Gajanan the clue to the robbery? I repeat the question. Who gives Inspector Gajanan the clue to the robbery? Now, Gajanan, Inspector, robbery. So these all things were there in chapter 4, isn't it so? Chapter 4, if you remember, students, the heading is How Gajanan Caught the Robbers. So this is from that chapter, chapter number 4. Okay, that is okay. Now options are given: Vikram, Puran, Charan, shopkeeper. So students, who according to you gave the clue to Inspector Gajanan? So if you have watched the video lectures when I was explaining you the story, if you remember the whole story, you will be able to answer. Okay, who gives the inspector clue of robbery? See, the information here, it is not asked that who gives the information. Okay, Charan, the owner of the house, calls Gajanan, but who gives the clue? So the answer is Puran, correct? Who was the cook? If you remember, Puran was the cook in Charan's house, and he was the one to give the clue by showing the three dogs. Okay, so Puran is the correct answer. So please repeat this once after me, students. Puran gives Inspector Gajanan the clue to the robbery. I hope, students, you are repeating after me, because this is very much important. If you repeat, keep on repeating this, you will be able to remember the sentences, and overall, if I ask you the questions in any way, you will be able to answer. Question 2. Who was Vikram? This is very basic question. Let me read the options first. The cook, the shopkeeper, the house owner, or the police constable. Who was the Vikram, students? Now again, if you are holding the textbooks, so in the first page itself, where the lesson starts from, the characters are given. See, Gajanan the police officer, Vikram the police constable. Okay, so there itself it is very much clear that Vikram was a dashk. I hope that you are speaking the answer, students. So the correct answer is the Vikram was police constable. So please repeat this sentence after me, my dear students. Vikram was the police constable. Repeat it last time. Vikram was the police constable. See, sometimes if a lot of characters are there, you get confused, correct? If you have not understood the story properly. So that is why it is must for you to repeat this. And you know, constable means a junior police officer, the one who is junior to the inspector or junior to the officer. Okay, moving on to the next question. How did Inspector Gajanan come to Charan's house? Obviously not by walking. So how did he come to Charan's house when Charan called inspector and he just reported about the robbery? So how did inspector came to Charan's house? How did Inspector Gajanan came to Charan's house? Now this is what you need to understand. You need to remember the story again. By car, by bus, by jeep, or by lorry. I hope that you are speaking the answers. If you know the answer, you are free to speak, students. So the correct answer is inspector came by jeep. Okay, if you remember, even if you have seen police inspector, they have their jeep, correct? So please repeat this after me. Inspector Gajanan came to Charan's house by a jeep. Please repeat it one more time. Inspector Gajanan came to Charan's house by jeep. Okay, so even if you don't remember this, you can remember that police inspectors always have their jeep with them. They travel using that jeep only. Okay, moving on. Fourth question is, what did the tall lady in the house give Jack the first time? Now here the story changes. Now in the fourth chapter there is no Jack, there is no tall lady. Okay, so obviously this is from chapter number 3. Like I said, both the questions are mixed. You need to be carefully pay attention here in the lecture, only then will you be able to solve this. I repeat the question, what did tall lady in the house give Jack the first time? Give Jack, if you remember that story, for the first time when the Jack went up from the beanstalk, Jack and the beanstalk, this story is Jack and the beanstalk. So for the first time when the Jack went up, climbing the beanstalk in the sky, if you remember, he met a tall lady for the first time who was standing on the doorstep, correct? So what did the tall lady give to Jack? Options are milk and cheese, bread and eggs, milk and toast, or bread and bacon. So what do you think, what do you remember by the story? What did the tall lady give the Jack to eat? If you remember, the Jack was insisting for having the breakfast. He was very much hungry since last night, so he wanted something to eat. So if you have textbook, again you can search into the textbook that what did the tall lady give. But some of you I know are very much smart, you know the answers on the tip of your tongue, you don't have to look even into the textbook, correct? So let us see what is the correct answer. And the correct answer is milk and cheese. So please repeat this line after me. The tall lady in the house gave milk and cheese to Jack the first time. Please repeat it one more time. The tall lady in the house gave milk and cheese to Jack the first time. Okay, I hope you remember now. Okay, now the fifth question is, how did the thieves enter the shop in the night? See, this is shop in, both the words are different, shop in the night. Okay, so how did the thieves enter? Again, this is again of story, the chapter number 4. Okay, how Gajanan caught the thieves. So this is not of third, this is of fourth chapter. So now again, if you try to remember that story, that it was revealed that how did thief and thieves enter the shop at the night. The thieves were caught from within the shop, okay, by Gajanan. But how did they enter the shop at night? The shop was closed, it was locked. So how did they enter? The options are here: through a broken window, through a tunnel, in a sack, or through an open window. So these are the ways, the options given. Now if you remember the story again, you will be able to answer this, how they entered the shop. So if you have the book, again you can go through it, it is clearly written there. If you remember, in scene 2 or 3 it is written how when the thieves were caught hold of by Inspector Gajanan, thieves confessed every little thing, what happened and how it happened, correct? So it is clearly written, the answer is they entered through a broken window, isn't it so? Okay, please repeat this after me. The thieves entered the shop in the night through a broken window. Okay, please repeat it one more time, one last time. The thieves entered the shop in the night through a broken window. Okay, they entered to the shop through a broken window. So that is also clearly written in the textbook itself, that thief, he himself confessed that they entered through the broken window and they as they saw the dogs chasing them. Moving on to the sixth question. Where does the Inspector Gajanan see three dogs barking? Now, when does he see? You know that as soon as he inquired everything, he wanted to ask certain questions to Charan, Puran and the helper about the robbery. He asked certain questions, he investigated, and then he just left the house. And then when he was on his way, he saw the dogs, three dogs barking. Those three dogs about which Puran described, correct? He gave the brief idea. So those three dogs inspector saw. But where? Okay, here are the options. Outside Charan's shop, near Puran's kitchen, next to his jeep, or outside his shop. So first option, outside Charan's shop. So in the story, can you see anywhere Charan's shop is being described? No, simply no. Charan's shop is never described in any scene, any of the scenes. Okay, so Charan's shop is wrong option. Near Puran's kitchen. Now Puran had his own kitchen. Puran did not have his own kitchen. He just worked into Charan's house. So okay, the dogs were not there in the house, so we cannot say near the kitchen. So these two options are there, next to his jeep or outside his shop. So now you have to think. So now if you remember the story again, you will be able to answer this, students. And I hope many of you are speaking the answers, many of you are actively participating it, and I appreciate you all. Let's see what the correct answer is. The correct answer is outside a shop, just outside a shop. Okay, so please repeat this sentence once after me. Inspector Gajanand saw three dogs barking outside a shop. Okay, let us move on to the next question. Next question is, what did Jack get from the cow he gave away? Again, moving on to the third chapter, Jack and the Beanstalk. Here the question is, what did the Jack get in the exchange of cow? He gave the cow to an old man. So what did he get in exchange? This is what we have discussed a whole lot of time. But the options are 5 silver seeds, 5 golden coins, 5 bean seeds, or 5 corn seeds. Answer is very, very easy. So let us see what the correct answer is. 5 bean seeds. Just repeat it once, because we have done it many times we have done this. So just repeat it once after me. Jack got 5 bean seeds for the cow he gave away. In short, he sold the cow and he got the cost of it, and the cost was 5 bean seeds given by an old man. Okay, question number 8. What did the poor woman tell Jack to do? Poor woman means Jack's mother and no one else, because Jack and his mother both were poor, no? So here poor woman refers to Jack's mother itself. So what did Jack's mother tell Jack to do? Options are kill the cow, sell the cow, buy another cow, or buy some milk. So one day, if you remember, cow stopped giving the milk. Cow did not give even a little milk. So what did Jack's mother tell him to do? So options. Now many of you have given me the answer. Let's see what the correct answer is. Sell the cow. Okay, that is why Jack sold the cow on the cost of 5 bean seeds, correct? So this is the correct answer. There is nothing to repeat here, because this answer is very easy. Moving on to the next question. What was poor woman's cow's name? Here I have twisted the question. Poor woman's cow's name. Poor woman again means Jack's mother. So what was Jack's cow's name? Options are Snow White, Rose Red, Chocolate Brown, Milky White. So what do you think was the name? Yes, 90% of you might be answering now. You all remember, this is very easy name, isn't it so, students? So So let me display the correct answer. Milky white. This is also we have repeated many a times, correct? Okay, lesson number 3 and 4, fill in the blanks. So now this is the second part of the revision worksheet where you have to fill in the blanks. Without wasting the time, question number 1, let me read it. The thief asks Gajanand to dash them with folded hands. So what does thief ask with the folded hands when he was caught? And if you are thinking about the answer, here is the correct answer. Forgive, correct? Forgive me. This is what the thief says. Please repeat it once after me, students. The thief asks Gajanand to forgive them with folded hands. Okay, so now I hope this is clear. And if you remember the story again, you don't have to remember, you learn the answer, you know, you don't have to by heart the answer, which otherwise you do, which is difficult for you. So the easiest way is to remember the story of the lesson. Second FB question is, the golden harp dashed beautifully. Did you observe something, students? Again, the topic changed means the lesson changed. This is from chapter number 3, correct? So the golden harp dashed beautifully. So what did the golden harp do on its own? Yes, I hope that many of you are speaking the answers and your answers are correct, might be incorrect. Let's see what the correct answer is. Sang means it is a past form of sing. Okay, so sing, sang, sung. These are the three forms. Anyways, let us not go into the grammar. Please repeat this after me. The golden harp sang beautifully. Please repeat it one last time. The golden harp sang beautifully. Okay, it sang and it played the music simultaneously, but it sang beautifully. Dashed beautifully, so it sang. And if you remember, on the order of sing, this was the giant's order. And with this, automatically, the harp started singing. Question 3. Jack cut the beanstalk into two with an dashk. Again, I repeat, Jack cut the beanstalk into two with an dashk. Means with what did he cut? If you remember, for the second time, when he stole the harp, when he had stolen that, he came down and after him, giant was also coming and Jack started cutting it for to save himself from the giant. Correct? So what did he cut the beanstalk with? Okay, the answer is here. An axe. Correct? I even showed you how the axe is while I was explaining you the lesson. So that is why I ask you to follow the lectures regularly, each and every lecture. So please repeat this once after me. Jack cut the beanstalk, I hope you are repeating, into two with an axe. A-X-E-X. A-N-E if you say both are silent. Only you have to pronounce X. Isn't it easy? Okay? Fine. Moving on to the next question. Inspector Gajanan. Okay. Now, again, chapter number 4. So, Inspector Gajanan is famous for solving crimes in -. Oh, two blanks. But students, answer is pretty easy. Why? Though the two blanks are there, the answer is of two words. That is what I am indicating you by placing two blanks here. So, Inspector Gajanan is famous for solving crimes in -. This is written within the starting of first scene itself. Okay. So, if you remember, it is written in your textbook that Inspector Gajanan is known for solving his crimes in no time. Oops, I said the answer. So, the correct answer is no time. Please repeat it once after me, my dear students. Inspector Gajanan is famous for solving crimes in no time. See, no time. Two words are there. नो टाइम मीन्स वॉट स्टूडेंट्स? इट इज क्लियरली रिटन इन द टेक्स्ट बुक इन अ शॉर्ट पीरियड ऑफ टाइम, करेक्ट? दिस इज द मीनिंग गिवन इन द टेक्स्ट बुक इट्स सेल्फ विथ अ शॉर्ट पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. ओके, सो दैट इंस्पेक्टर वॉज फेमस फॉर दैट. क्वेश्चन 5. जैक हिड इन ए बिग डैश ऑन हिज सेकेंड विजिट टू द जायंट्स हाउस. दिस इज ऑल्सो प्रिटी ईजी स्टूडेंट्स. फॉर द सेकेंड टाइम वेन ही वेंट, सो अगेन दिस इज ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 3 स्टूडेंट्स. सो फॉर द सेकेंड टाइम वेन द जैक वेंट टू द जायंट्स हाउस, वेर डिड ही हिड हिमसेल्फ? इफ यू रिमेंबर, नाउ फॉर द सेकेंड टाइम इवन द टॉल वुमेन डिड नॉट नो दैट द जैक इज देयर इन द हाउस. सो इफ यू रिमेंबर द स्टोरी, यू मस्ट रिमेंबर द आंसर एज वेल. ओके, सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग द टाइम लेट मी डिस्प्ले द आंसर. कॉपर पॉट. ओके, सो दोज हु आर नॉट नोइंग दिस आंसर, प्लीज रिपीट दिस आफ्टर मी. जैक हिड इन ए, प्लीज रिपीट स्टूडेंट्स, इन ए बिग कॉपर पॉट ऑन हिज सेकेंड विजिट टू द जायंट्स हाउस. क्लियर इनफ? कॉपर पॉट, जस्ट रिमेंबर दिस. फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम ही हिड इन द ओवन एंड फॉर द सेकेंड टाइम कॉपर पॉट. ओके, सिक्स्थ क्वेश्चन इज द कुक डैश्ड वॉज द डैश टू लीव द हाउस. ओके, हियर टू ब्लैंक्स आर देयर एंड दिस इज ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 4. Obviously, how Gajanan caught the thief, because Cook is only in that story. Cook Puran, if you remember, the cook dash was the dash to leave the house. So in the first blank, obviously the name is there, and was the dash to leave the house. So when at the time of robbery, he was dash to leave the house. First, second, third, last. Let us see the answer. So the cook Puran. So Puran belongs to these blanks and last belongs to these blanks. So the cook Puran was the last to leave the house. Please repeat it after me. The cook Puran was the last to leave the house. Clear enough? Moving on to the seventh blanks. Here again two blanks are there. Please read it carefully. The sacks were filled with dash and dash. Sack, if you remember, that big kind of cloth container in which the grains were filled, correct? So the sacks were filled with dash and dash. So what was there inside the sacks? Okay, so let us see what the answer is. Vegetables and grains, correct? Please repeat this after me. The sacks were filled with vegetables and grains. Okay? It is not vegetables, it's vegetables. Okay? Second is silent. So now I hope you will remember this. Moving on to the next question. So the next question is, the day Milky White gave no milk, there was no dash and no dash in the house. Again, I repeat the question. The day Milky White gave no milk, there was no dash and no dash in the house. So there were two things absent in the house the day Milky White gave no milk. So this story is again, this question is again from the story of chapter number 3. Milky White is only in that story. So what was not there in the house when Milky White did not give anything? So because of which the Jack's mother took the step of selling the cow? Answer is money and food. This is what they wanted, isn't it so? Okay, just repeat it once after me, students. The day Milky White gave no milk, there was no money and no food. in the house. Okay? So, with this, students, that is the end of today's lecture. Thanks for watching video lecture, and I hope that you are watching with keen interest, and also you are answering, you are speaking along with me, because that is what you can't do in the class, but here you are getting the opportunity to speak as louder as you can at the top of your lungs. Okay? So I'll bring the next interesting lecture, and I hope that you are going to watch each and every lecture of each and every subjects, and you are going to do homework regularly. Till then, stay safe. Goodbye.